In this video, I'm going to show you how you can easily add captions to your videos. Hi, I'm Andy from TechSmith. Creating captions for your videos has never been easier. Today, I'm going to cover 5 of the simplest ways that you can add captions to your videos. Number 1. The most obvious way involves the platform we're on right now. Once you're inside YouTube's Studio Editor, you can go to the Subtitles panel and choose to add new subtitles or closed captions. We've already added 2 different languages for this one, and now we want to add our English subtitles. I can either search it here in the language search bar or choose from the one in the dropdown. This bottom option allows you to see YouTube's auto-transcription and even jump in and edit what they've already done. The middle one allows you to type along as your subject speaks, manually entering your captions. And this top option is for uploading an SRT or subtitle file. If you've already created one like I have, click here. I'll show you how to make these in the next step. So I click upload a file, choose my file, click upload. But before I do that, you can see in the background they've auto-transcribed my subtitles and they're usually pretty close. But we're going to replace those by uploading our own just to make sure they're accurate. And if I wish to edit it, I can go through and click on any one of them to make changes. But this is good, so I'm going to hit publish, and it's that simple. If you choose to use their auto-transcription, it's very simple to go in and make any edits you need to after it's finished. Number 2 and 3. Since we at TechSmith are the makers of the screen recording video editing software Camtasia, link in the description below for a free trial, both the second and third equally awesome ways to create captions are inside our software. Inside Camtasia, using the same video as an example, you can add captions by going under the audio effects, which for me is under the More button here, then audio effects and captions. Click it and drag it down to your audio track, which is also my video track in this case, and it automatically shows you the waveform and splits the captions into 4-second increments right here. Those are completely adjustable, so if you want to make this one go towards the end of this clip, done, and so on. The way to get these captions typed in is as easy as clicking the first one and just start transcribing. How do you extract the text from an image? Okay, I'll stop there and say, well, the word image was somewhere close to about here. Move to my next clip, and so on. And you do this as you go through the entire video, clicking on each caption that you want to add. Another nice option about this is maybe you're not the fastest typer and you want to be able to try and keep up with what your speaker's saying, but it just goes by too fast. So you click the caption you want to hear, and this play button that has the looping arrows will play the selected clip continuously until you're able to get the caption written down. As you do that, you go through all of your captions, adjusting for the right duration, so that we don't have too long of a caption on screen at any one given time, and so it makes sense where the caption breaks are. The other thing is, because this video was going on YouTube, I knew I wanted to have 20 seconds of silence at the end, just a little bit of music maybe, so the video would keep playing with end cards. Well, I don't need captions over that, so I'm gonna right click and say merge with next caption, and again, merge with next caption, over and over, until I get the last one. And there, now we have a blank caption for the last few seconds. And just that easy, we made our captions in Camtasia. When we're done, you can go to Share, Export Captions. And when we do that, it brings up the window for you to save them, and it's a good practice to name it the same as your video. So for us, it's Episode 1, Extract Text. I can even click right here on this one, Episode 1, and that way it'll be the same name. Then it saves right where I tell it to. One quick note, subtitles and captions are not the same thing. They're close, so they're often confused. Captions usually include visual descriptions of sound happening in your video, cars honking, dogs barking, whereas subtitles are just straight transcription of your words and often are referring to the translation of multiple languages as well. The second way that I like to add captions inside Camtasia is only available in Windows. If you're a Mac user, hang in there for a minute, but you Windows users are gonna love this. Over here in Camtasia's side tab, see we have our video down there in the player, just go to More, then Captions. And this brings up this big open window on the left, and you can either import your script if it's already written out, or click Add Caption, and I'm gonna do that. And it adds this one caption, and I'm gonna stretch it the entire length of my video, though actually you can see this one was also given 20 seconds of quiet music at the end for YouTube, so I'll just stretch it as far as the audio goes. Then I'm going to click in here, and I've already copied it from my document. I'm just gonna paste it right into this window. And there's my whole script. And you can see it on the left-hand side here as well. One quick note is that up at the top, you'll see this space occurred, and we want to get rid of that. Spacing matters in subtitle files, and so we need to get rid of that, so I'm just going to take this top line and just backspace or delete and get us to the top. Now, we're gonna go to Modify, Captions, and we're gonna choose Sync Captions. And what this will do is allow the video to play as we tell it what words she's saying. So we hit Sync Captions. So I'm gonna hit Continue, and it's going to start playing, and as it does, I can say right now she's at this point. Hi is the next word.
In this video, I'm going to show you how to quickly copy text from just about anything. Let's get started.
She says that word, you just keep clicking as it happens, and she says,
so,
and you just keep going until you're done.
This,
if you need to pause for any reason, you pause. If you're ready to stop and you're done, you hit stop. And you'll see the captions are being created right down here below. If you've already gotten your script written down, this is a great method and saves a ton of time. Number four. Many of you may not have heard of this next one, but TechSmith's newest video platform, Knowmia, I've put a free trial in the description for Knowmia as well, has an amazing and super simple speech-to-text option. So here's Knowmia, one of TechSmith's newest platforms. If I go down to the details inside of my videos, one of the options down here in the tabs is accessibility. Under accessibility, we'll find our captions. And right now we have no caption tracks, so I'm gonna add one. And right here, the first option is speech-to-text. Automatically generate captions for this video. I click apply, and while we may have to wait a bit, it's gonna start transcribing them for us automatically. And the great thing is you're gonna get an email when your transcribing has finished, so you don't have to sit around and wait for it. All right, I've just received the email saying my captions are now created, and here they are. It says ready to edit, so I'm gonna go ahead and click the three dots and jump in to edit them. And then you can go through, take a look at them, and just make sure that all of the captions turned out correctly. Does it look okay? Are things spelled right? Did we get her name correct? Yes, we did. And we just keep going until you find any spelling or grammar errors at your own leisure. When you're done, click publish. And that's it. Now, when people play back this video, they can choose the option to have closed captions on or off. Side note, when you upload your captions to Knowmia, your viewers can search your video captions to find sections most pertinent to what they want to learn. That's good for SEO, too. Number five, when you have a lot of captions to do and don't want to do all the heavy lifting of adding all those captions, it's probably worth paying a website like Rev.com or others to do the work for you. Just think of the benefits adding captions to your videos is going to yield for both you and your audience. Have you used captions before? What's your favorite workflow for creating them? Do you write them longhand or have them automatically transcribed? Tell us in the comments below, we want to know. And remember, if you enjoyed this video, give it a like and subscribe to our channel for more great content. Thanks for watching.